While it all started with Black Widow, who truly came into her own with 2012's The Avengers, 5 years later, poor Scarlett Johansson, it looks like it will be Wonder Woman who finally proves to the suits in Hollywood that female superheroes are worth the investment, and a better route to go than the love interest, which has been the movie standard for decades, despite comics, animation, and to some degree even television already having successfully made the switch. And interestingly, you have to give credit where credit is due. This is one of the few areas where the DCEU is and has been ahead of the curve. Batman v Superman, most popular character, Wonder Woman, now rewarded with a solo movie that is not only the best reviewed DCEU movie yet, but is just a well-reviewed movie, period. Then, of course, Harley Quinn ran away with Suicide Squad, and she's being rewarded with her own movie. We'll see if she's the lead or if it ends up being truly a group movie, Gotham City Sirens, but we'll see Poison Ivy and Catwoman return to the screen likely in that film as well, and maybe a couple of other strong female characters. And in fact, as female superheroes finally find their groove on the silver screen, it looks like female villains are not far behind. Again, we have to give credit where credit is due. Feyora kicked it off in Man of Steel. Fabulous performance, great fight scene on Main Street in Smallville. You can watch that on a loop. In fact, I have watched it on a loop. But of course, Cate Blanchett in Thor Ragnarok is getting a ton of attention. And if they make a Wonder Woman sequel, which it seems they are likely to do at this point, odds are very strong that one of her iconic female villains will also jump to the silver screen. And in fact, I made a casting video about who should play the likes of Cheetah, Circe, and Veronica Kale, which you can check out via the link in the video description. Now, interestingly, part of Warner Brothers' success here is that they are trusting women behind the camera on these projects. Patty Jenkins, of course, integral to Wonder Woman's success. And also, even Margot Robbie has been up to producer on Gotham City Sirens. So I think that's perhaps one of the reasons these characters are coming across so authentic, and that they have strong women not only portraying them, but behind them creatively. But we also have to give credit to what male talent behind the camera is contributing. Zack Snyder, he cast Gal Gadot and helped create the story for her solo film. David Ayer reimagined Harley Quinn to make her not only more popular than she's ever been, but in a way that won an Oscar for hair and makeup. Jeff Johns helped Alan Heinberg with his script for Wonder Woman, which again is an incredibly well-reviewed movie. And James Wan's first look at his version of Mira that he recently released on Twitter was incredibly well received. And since Mira is in the Justice League movie, it's likely she'll be first in line to be that team's second female member. I hope they add another female member soon. But then also Joss Whedon has signed on to do a solo Batgirl movie. And Joss Whedon also was in the news recently when it comes to the DCEU because he's taking over the Justice League reshoots and finishing that film up for Zack Snyder, who of course suffered a horrible family tragedy. I don't think that Joss Whedon is going to change that film in any way. I think he's going, because it would be a horrible thing to do to hijack someone's film under those circumstances, he's just going to complete it as Snyder and his team originally intended. He might have some creative input, but he'll be taking a back seat creatively to Snyder, as he should. But still, the fact that he was chosen for this, I mean, he is available because he kind of shot himself in the foot PR-wise with a lot of his tweets lately and how he imploded over at the MCU. But still, the fact that he was selected to do this means he's very quickly become a part of the inner family at the DC, or the inner circle at the DCEU. And I'm glad he's so enthusiastic, and I hope that he doesn't fly off the rails again. But that would mean to me that they're probably going to reward him for doing this with his Batgirl movie sooner rather than later. Also, Joss Whedon, of course, was largely responsible for the success that Black Widow, the limited success, unfortunately, that Black Widow has enjoyed. But he did get in trouble for that a little bit. That's part of what led to his implosion with what he decided to do with her backstory in the second Avengers film. But I think you also have to give credit to the Russo brothers, who did a lot with Black Widow by just glamming her up a bit in both Captain America movies. And perhaps that's the problem with Black Widow, in that there hasn't been a clear direction to go with her over in the MCU. Is she this, like, girl power figure that Joss Whedon imagined? This tragic, tortured one, or is she a slick femme fatale as the Russo brothers see her? It would be a hard decision to make, and so maybe that's what Kevin Feige is waiting on. And I'm sure he's also waiting on Wonder Woman's box office numbers. But then there are some other female characters set to debut in the DCEU. Zatanna, if they do make that Dark Universe movie, aka Justice League Dark, and decide to sue Universal over the title Dark Universe, I don't think that DC uses Dark Universe enough to lay claim to that, quite frankly. But Zatanna has Harley Quinn potential. From her fishnets, whether she's wearing them on her legs or arms, oddly, but I think in particular with her magic skills, which I think will be quite cinematic. If you have any question about that, go watch her end battle in Justice League Dark, the animated movie, and you will see how amazing she could be. But who else? There's actually, I think, not a lot of contenders. I think, like, for instance, Black Canary is a little too TV. I don't think that her power set is cinematic enough to make the jump to the big screen. But I do think that Hawk Girl would be fantastic. The only problem is that she's forever attached to Hawkman. It's so annoying. But now you have an example of how to do her right and how to do her wrong. But Jon Stewart is incredibly popular as one of the Green Lanterns because of his stint on the Justice League animated series. And I hope the DCEU recognizes that Hawk Girl is just as popular because, of course, of her romance with that character on the show. Also, she's a brawler, and they redesigned her quite well. When she lost the helmet, I'm telling you, helmets do not work with I mean, they might work sometimes in the comics, but I don't think they work particularly well in animation and movies, etc. But when she lost that helmet on the animated series, she really took off, and I see tremendous potential for her on the big screen. Now, I know a lot of you also want to see Vixen stop ruining these characters, the CW, because she can only bring diversity to the team. The DCEU still has to work on their diversity. I think maybe all the comic book movies do to some degree. But she, of course, was also popular on the animated series. But what I think holds Vixen back is that her power set is very hard to portray, and it's also hard to follow, I think, for non-comic book readers. Now she's using the power of a snake, and you're like, she just looks like she, you know, Black Widow does that all the time, and she's not calling on any snake power, so I'm confused. I can see that happening. And then here's my third choice for someone else that they should consider, another female superhero, Jade. Now you might be wondering, why wouldn't you go with the current female Green Lantern, Jessica Cruz? Well, Jessica Cruz doesn't have glowing green skin. Again, the key here is cinematic. Look how popular Mystique is. Why not bring Jade into the mix? Her father is the first Green Lantern, Alan Scott, and the reason that she has glowing green skin is that her power, well, it's complicated. Her power is internalized. She doesn't need a Green Lantern ring to manipulate Green Lantern energy, which is pretty awesome. But apparently her skin is green, like Poison Ivy's skin is green, because her mother, Thorn, has plant powers. That's too confusing. She doesn't need to have Green Lantern and plant powers. That's like comic book like confusion. You don't need that for the mainstream audience. I think having an internal battery, basically, Green Lantern battery, would be enough to give her glowing green skin. I think she would look amazing on the big screen. Imagine, you know, if, for instance, Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 2, when you have Yondu using his arrow, it's just so cool to see it in the dark, the red glowing. So what if you were to have Jade not only having her powers glowing in the dark, but herself as well? It would be amazing. She also has an awesome evil twin brother, Obsidian, who is basically a living shadow. Also quite cinematic. So do you like the way the DCEU is handling its female characters? Why do you think they're having so much success where other cinematic universes are not? I mean, Marvel's doing very well with Scarlet Witch, Scarlett Johansson, but you know, they're not quite as front and center as the DCEU female superheroes. Who's your favorite so far? And also, who are you looking forward to seeing? And who do you hope to see? Write your thoughts down below, and we shall indeed see what changes Wonder Woman brings about, not only in the DCEU, but across the board in Hollywood. And you can check out some more Wonder Woman coverage right now. We'll be right back.